If you are going to paint with me, make sure that you are going to stretch if you haven't already. Have something to drink next to you. I have my trusty off-brand soda. That happens to be my favorite. The off-brand version is my favorite. And that you have gotten something to eat or have something to eat next to you. And if you're painting something with me, I would love to hear about it in the chat as we go through this. Now this piece is very much a lot more of a practice piece in the sense that I am doing a lot more background this time. This is a drow. I keep forgetting the word for drow. Silly me. But I am painting a drow, sort of peeking into the trees, to make sure that they're not intruding on anything or scouting. It depends on how you want to see this. But as I showed, but you couldn't hear what I was saying, I am using Pose My Art this time. Otherwise, I often use Adora's stock as well, although that I do some more in my personal time. That feels a little less than professional to do so for streams. But Pose My Art, like I said, I've paid for the subscription. If you are an artist, I highly recommend it as well. You go from having a few of the poses available, and none of these tools, like you can see these bushes. They're gonna be bushes. You don't get those without the subscription, and you don't get a lot of the other pose options. That being said, I think I am ready to hop in. So because this is a drow, we're gonna hop into sort of DB purple, which is going to make this a little more difficult to shade, but necessary. And on top of the shading is where I am going to put the scars, because there are going to be scars on this one. I kind of adore putting scars on characters, because it's a little bit of a shortcut to going, hey, this character has seen and felt some shit. And I think it's really fun when you can add that little bit of flavor to a character. So I do that at every chance that I can. So I'm gonna do the scars first, because they get pretty specific, and there's not a lot of skin that I'm showing with this one. So I can do that right now. We're gonna start here. And scars are often, usually, say I have a scar here, which I do. I have several body modifications that have faded, but they often fade in like a line, so that they're a little bit lighter than the skin tone most of the time. So that's where I'm gonna be going with that. And I'm gonna make that just a little bit, like 85% there. Actually, what I may do, no, I'll set it at 100, and if it feels better that it's not at that, then I will knock it down in opacity on the layer itself. That's what I think I'm gonna do. Yeah, scars I think are also another place where I think you can have a lot of fun in a painting. I don't do them as much because a lot of times I'm trying to challenge myself with the clothes more. I still don't think that I challenge myself quite enough with the clothes, but that takes time and it takes practice. So one thing at a time, you know. You pick and choose your battles whenever you do a piece that you're trying to challenge yourself with, and that's going to be another one. That's going to be another piece. For now, I think I'm going to play with some scarage and some background, especially since background is something I never do. And then I think if I want to do this, then I can make the tool for the shading a lot, like, harsher, so it won't fade out as much. and with a lot less pressure. We don't wanna feed this line bait all that much. You just want it to know that it's there, you know? So you know that that has happened. I might make that a little bit darker, just because that still feels as I see it in the darkness. That still feels like a little bit light for that skin tone. So I'm gonna redo it. There we go. That feels a little bit more... feels a little bit more reasonable and a little bit more realistic as D&D can get, of course. So that's what I'm gonna do here. Now I know I could do this multiple strokes, but I think I am just going to try to fill that in while my eyes are on this specific thing. There we go. And then, just as I did before, where I overlapped the sort of scar line, as I have it, I'm gonna clean up. There we go. And there we go. And now, I can bring in that tool that I just used and soften that up so it looks a lot more like faded and old. And that already, that looks so much better. It's a lot less in your face things have happened. The next scar we're going to do is on this hand. It's a little hard to see because of the drow skin tone, but we're gonna hop in and do it. This, I'm not sure where this scar came from. I just sort of picture this sort of star sort of shape, however many points that star happens to have, on someone who has been, like, stabbed in the hand. And I don't know what this character did to get, how this character ended up getting this scar, but I do think it invokes a question of what the heck happened there, and that's what I'm trying to evoke sometimes with my pieces of art. And again... we're gonna sort of fade it out just so you know that it's old. But you know something happened to that hand. And then, the last place that I really put a scar, because I didn't want to overdo it. There are other more important parts of this piece. That I don't want to outshine. That's here. One of those classic right over the eye scars. And then we're gonna clean that up a little bit. How was everyone's weekend, by the way? Mine was a little bit tired, but I have a little bit more free of a schedule now, which I think I'm a little relieved about, even if it wasn't acquired through the best of means. But I am glad that I was able to watch some MasterChef with some family, which was really, really enjoyable. And I kind of got to relax with them that I really enjoyed. And we're going to save just to make sure that we are not going to lose any of the progress that we make. I had this happen last week, I want to say. I finished all the painting on a project, and then... I realized as the art program crashed, first time the art program has crashed in like the 2 years, I think, that I've been using this art program, and I lost all of the progress, so make sure that you're saving. And here we're going to do eyes and mouth, because that mouth is also going to have shading. Now, I know you might be thinking, what about the nose? But the nose gets shaded with the nose gets handled with the shading level layer, just to make sure that we know that there's that depth. It's very different from the shape of the mouth and the eyes. So, I think I need to take a look at what what those eyes look like. Drow eyes. Red eyes. We're going with red. Thank you, Google. No, I use Bing. I use Bing on this computer. So we're going to pop into red here. And I'm thinking we get... This is a pretty good red. This is a pretty good red. And then we're just going to create sort of the eye shape. No, I'm actually just going to see where I think with the lighting. I think this makes sense. I think where the eyes seem feel like they're looking, that makes sense. All right. So, how have your guys weekend been? Like I said, I had more time on my hands than I'm kind of used to having, but I enjoyed it. I got to relax this weekend for the first time in a little while in the last week, which is why I haven't been streaming. I had a little bit of a personal crisis that I needed to handle first before I could do anything else. That being said, I am feeling pretty good now. I'm actually going to put a little tinge of this purple here. Not overly noticeable, of course, because we don't want to drown out that red, that beautiful red that's going to stand out. But, I'm going to put that in. There we go. Sometimes. Okay, and then I will clean that up after I've done everything else. Alright, let's... I wonder, actually, I am going to do something kind of fun and dangerous, and I'm going to use the anti-alias edge. Because it makes it a lot more round. A lot more safe to... Sort of, yeah, it creates this effect. And it's a little less pixelated. I am usually entirely fine with the pixelation on these things. But I think I need to sort of... I've sort of been getting better at going, this is a good place for some good old pixelation. For some good old anti-alias edge. Because, like, these lines here, that's creating this brow bone, that is also done with an anti-alias edge. And it makes it a little bit less noticeable. A little bit less in your face that's happening. And I think that's kind of the effect you want to have sometimes. So I think I'm sort of starting to balance that out and include that in my pieces, but not to an overwhelming degree, if that makes any sense. A balanced out art tool diet, if that, as it were. Allow me a moment. There we go. Make sure that you're hydrating as you're painting, as you're just hanging out with me, or painting, rather, if you are. Painting, I actually have been sort of hopping back into painting for the last week. I haven't had much motivation as I was dealing with things to paint. So it's been really nice to hop back into the saddle, the metaphorical artistic saddle with this. But the last few days, it's been really nice and super relaxing. It's been a relief, as this is a lot of how, like, I sort of stim, as it engages my hands. I think I've talked about that before on stream. So it's been really nice to have this a little bit more back in my arsenal, where this is something I have the energy for. Gotta respect your energy levels, even when it's inconvenient. Sometimes your body and your brain, it's telling you you need to take a break and you need to rest, as much as you might not want to hear it. And so that's what I have been doing, not painting and such. Let me go here, clean that up. Now this should be all right. There we go. And, actually, this looks a lot more irritated in a fun way, in a fun dynamic way, than I was kind of expecting it to come out. So I am appreciating this already. We're going to set this to 80, and we're going to take away the Antialias edge. Antialias edge. I don't even know if I'm saying it right, so I apologize if you do know that, know how to say it, and I am saying it wrong. Because I probably am, but I'm doing my best. So we're just going to sort of create this depth here so that you know that the lips are there and that they're not just being tucked away and hidden, and that, so that you can't see it in the depth of this sort of purpley blue shade that is the skin. And then I think I'm actually going to make my brush one time smaller. I'm gonna make that, there we go. Almost black. Really dipping into the, There we go. And now, I will save most of the, I will often save most of the shading of the lips for the shading of this layer. But, I'd want to make sure that you can really see the dynamic and the shape of what's happening here. Now we're gonna crank up the softness. There we go. Now it really feels like you're getting some of that shape on the mouth. And this is not a very impressed looking drow, you know what I mean? So, next, I'm actually going to go into the pose layer and then put behind it background reference, because I need to put a completely unrelated color that is sort of complimentary that you can sort of see. I will be watching the chat, but if you can think of, hello to the person who just joined, by the way, if you can think of a color that sort of you might be able to see white against all the sort of colors that we've got going on here, let me know, because I will also be watching the chat as I try to figure that out for myself. Colors that go well with purple and white. I'm gonna go with green. I think I'm gonna go with green. There's also gonna be other green. Hello, steampunk. Where have you been called out? I'm very curious. I think I'm going to go with green, just so I have a reference point for when I need to clean stuff up for shading. And also because I'm gonna be using white for this hair. So, let's go with sort of this green. You should be able to see everything just fine here with this one. We're just gonna do this so you can see everything under it. And it'll be very easy to sort of see the shading that's supposed to happen, and where it gets messy. There we go. And then now I can do hair. I don't know why I was about to layer this mouth, but it's the hair layer. Now I am going to make this tool fudge cakes. Not what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to make this tool a lot smaller. And now you see what I mean. I needed that good layer there. But now, because I have that, I can clean up against that. But I am going to put that here, here, and here. And then turn this on just so I can know where I might be missing any nooks and crannies from line art. There we go. I think I didn't miss anything. This is usually a pretty surefire way, and then you just have to clean up little areas like right over here Which is what I'm gonna be doing. There we go. How has your day been, by the way? Steampunk. I got up a few, like about an hour and a half ago, 2 hours, just to make sure that I knew I would stream. I have a pretty bad habit of sleeping in sometimes. And now, oh, I can't believe I almost forgot. We're gonna get the hairbrush tool. And this is how I usually do my brows. My brain shorts are here for a moment. Don't mind me. Alright. Oh, that's what a white one looks like. Because of the undertones. So let's... No, let's do this. And then put that back in this sort of gradient. Now this is going to look not great at first. Yeah. Yeah, this is not going to look great at first. We're going to have to clean it up. But I always start with just a big old chunk of hair that I can then clean up in whatever fashion that I would think this character, that the character that I'm drawing would have for brows. Oftentimes I will forget to do brows because, as you can see, I have them. So a lot of times personal bias can lead me to, you know, forget that other people have them. It gets a little bit more peripheral white noise, visual white noise, if that makes any sense. So this is something that I absolutely tried to make sure that I have in my pieces. And now comes time to clean it up. Because you don't want these little edges here. There we go. Now, I absolutely think it doesn't go all the way to this middle either. Now, this is an unamused drow. There we go. Let's see how I feel about... yeah, no, I like the way his brows look there, in terms of the arch there. He looks very unamused and of, like, really? In the way of, like, really? This is what they're doing? And I think that's really interesting to see in a painting. Oh gosh, okay. Now something I need to be careful of that I am not always careful enough of is because the brows are on the same layer as the hair, and the brows are very close to the hair, you're going to want to be careful to make sure that you're not getting into that by way of that. You know what I mean? So you want to be careful and mindful of that. Now let's clean up here. Trying to think. And as I said in the beginning of the stream, in case you were not here, if you are painting alongside me, absolutely feel free to let me know what you're doing. I'm very curious to see what people might be making alongside me while we hang out. There we go. And then there. And then I think we round that out. And this is a lot more of a realistic kind of person that's just a little bit sick of people's shit. then we just... Let's see. What do I think? I think I like this one. He absolutely looks unamused here, which is what I'm going for. It's very hard to see some of the background, but with shading that will become easier. So now we're going to turn this back off. There we go. And we are going to input the wrappings. We're going to color in the wraps. There we go. I hope everyone who's joining us today, as is having a good day, by the way. I'm certainly having a better day than I was a few days ago, which is always very good to feel like. No one likes a stressful day. I am watching the chat, by the way, so if you are hanging out and you have any thoughts, questions, anything like that, absolutely just ask them and I will answer to them best of my ability. Now I will clean up with some of the bits of pixelated areas that this isn't quite getting in with a second stroke of here. I also prefer to do this oftentimes. Just in case, I want to see what it looks like without all the line art. Sometimes that's what I try to do. Just to see if that is a style that, like, I might be able to do. And some people can make it work, some people do not, and that's entirely okay. There we go. There we go. I think very briefly, as I was figuring out this art program in the first place a few years ago, I did try that style where I didn't have a lot of line art happening with the final products that I was making. But I think this is the style that I've really landed in that I'm happy with, and I like this. And I like the way that that it looks to me. And now I'm gonna save this piece and go to another layer. We're gonna go with pant. Although we're not going to see most of these pants. We're going to see like one knee, which is this, and then the beginning of another knee here, I believe. It's a little bit hard to see, I admit. So not my strength here, but it does the job. There we go. All right, so we're going to have to go in to these little holes between there, just to make sure that we are getting every single spot. And thankfully we'll be protected from getting into the skin layer with the help of trusty erasing tool. Alright. And then I make sure that there's this. Now I don't do the whole make sure that there's something in the layer, in the like line art, under the line art, with all the layers. I'm not as good about that. But that's alright. Different strengths. Now and then we're gonna go for the vest. And as well, the background shading is going to be done entirely differently. I'm going to be shading the figure first before I do anything else, and then I will do lighting last after all of this is done. So theoretically, hopefully I will be getting another stream in of this particular piece because it's coming out pretty well and I feel pretty pleased with it. Alright, so I think I'm going to put this gray back in. Now with rogues I tend to use a lot of like black and grays, and I'd be very good about this is what the theme is for certain classes. I think it's this screams rogue, and if it doesn't, I don't know what kind of rogues you've been playing. But I would be interested to hear about them because it's fun to find new takes on the rogue. Pretty well done at this point. Plus, I don't think we need to reinvent the wheel with the drow and the rogue. I think they're pretty well done at this point. And we can put this here. Put a little bit of shine on these buttons. There we go. And there we go. We have the vest. And then last but not least, I will be doing the handkerchief. And I think when I was painting the line art for this handkerchief, I had in mind I wanted it to be red. Like bright red. In your face, cannot ignore that this is a red handkerchief. It's a little brighter than his eyes. So I might undo that. I have not yet decided. Actually, I think I'm okay with this. With it like this. I think a classic handkerchief is a really good option here. And you have the folds, and it sort of folds here, just the way that you sort of expect most handkerchiefs to do. So that's just where we're going to put it. So I'm going to save, and then we are going to begin shading. Here is where the background layer is going to become helpful, because I'm going to put the skin shading down, I'm going to shade it, and then I'm going to clean it up using that as a reference tool so I can see where the blended parts have not hit. Okay, oh no, oh, not what we want. Let's get this dark shade here. I'm gonna set this to 90, I think. 90 opacity. Just so it's like almost entirely a level of paint, layer of paint. We're gonna set that to 10. See how that fares. Yes, that's good. Alright, awesome. Oh, yes. Glorious. Okay. I can actually even probably go a little bit lighter with that. I probably don't need to go too much lighter than that, but that's good. That is a good size thing. I can also probably make this smaller as well. You don't usually find it that big in terms of like the shading on your hands and such. That's not usually where they're not usually that dark. Also, something of note. I had a thought, and then I lost it. My apologies. I may take a minute just to do a little bit of stretching once I've sort of placed all this down. Now you'll notice, because of the way that I've done the layers, this is going down smoothly in that. Like in some places, like right here, I am absolutely going over that line. But you aren't seeing it, because of just how well that's been done. Just, the layer work. And with that, thankfully with a shading color this strong, we're not going to need too much of the help from the background color that I've chosen for this. Just because this will be very, very easy to see. It's very in your face. I imagine, mayhaps, the more we paint of this dude, the more we realize, man's not happy. but mostly, I imagine, it's more of a party thing. His party is probably being doofuses, to put it kindly. And he's sort of keeping watch. I'm not quite sure the scenario that I have in mind with this yet. If you'll allow me a moment. You have to make sure to hydrate. Hydrate's very good for you. Hydrating. I can word. That's what this whole thing is, isn't it? Okay. Now that's not usually as direct as I would normally make this, but I will make a darker one there. Alright. Now I think I'm going to have to clean up around the scar as well. Yeah, I'm gonna put the scar layer below the skin shading. Merge it down. There we go. There we go, there we go. That's what I'm looking for. Okay. That answered for. I always shade this hairline. And when I have paid attention to the ears, that is also where I might put that too. But I am going to make this too a little bit smaller for this part. Alright. No. I'm gonna redo that real quick. Yeah, we're gonna layer that up here. Because when that gets shaded, that is going to show. And then we're gonna put a little bit more opacity here. Which means we can layer this and it'll actually be effective still. There we go. Yeah, with this nose, I find it a lot easier with this nose to be able to shade it in a way that's like dynamic and has depth. But we cannot forget the most important part of the face for me. And that is cheekbones. I'm going to put this at 70. There we go. Let's see what we're working with here. How badly? I think I like that. Now, and it's not just shading. We also need to put like the way that the face is highlighted. We cannot forget that. That is extremely important. There are many points of highlight on the face, especially with the way that this one is being painted, with the campfire light. It's just gonna be shaded a little bit differently. I'm gonna first do the natural lighting, and then on top of it, after I finished the shading of the trees and such, that is when I'll be doing the fire lighting on top of it. Just to add that dimension and depth. That we're seeing. That one would see. And now we're gonna go back to 90 opacity. And the 5 size tool. There we go. Put that there. And we put this here. There we go. I hope everyone that's watching is having a good day, by the way. I know I keep saying that, but in case someone is popping in and out, you don't really know. I don't really know who that might be. So I just want to put that out there. I hope you're having a good day. Especially, like, right now. Like, we all deserve to have a good day. There we go. Yeah. There we go. And then let me clean this up. I will, again, have to clean this up after anyways. But I'm doing it now just in case. Just to save myself some time. This is going to create the fact that this is a three-dimensional arm. Once I put the lighting in and I begin to shade. You know? Very important that we do this. There we go. you go. There we go. Awesome. Now, is anyone here watching The Legend of Vox Machina? Has anyone watched that? I know I mentioned it in previous streams, but I'm holding off on watching it because I don't want to finish it. If that makes sense. I'll watch every episode twice, before I feel like I can move on, and I've watched episodes 9 through 10, or Brain. I have watched episodes 6 through 9, 7 through 9, at least once, and then I have yet to watch the Q&A. But has anyone found that to be like good? Been really interested in, and once I know that there's more in watching that. I also have the same thing about Sword Art Online. I know a lot of people give it flack for being like a bunch of tropes stuck like in a piloting a trench coat, but like I think sometimes all you want is a trench coat piloted by a bunch of tropes. I think that sometimes that's what people want, and some people might be a little bit more aware of that. That's why it has like such a big following. Let's see what happens if I put this here. What color is it? There we go. Actually, with the lighting, I think I can probably put it at 69 is a funny number, yeah? I think this is a good place to place that. Good place to put that. We're gonna shade the hand, the fingers specifically, in a moment. We do not wanna completely be kind of lazy about this, which I know is tempting sometimes. Trust me, I get it. Not always thing you want to do when something can pretty easily just be ignored, but it's this sort of detail that has people going, "Whoa, that is really good." And that's detail I try to put in when I have the spoons and the energy, of course. It's not all the time when you have that, but sometimes you get lucky and you do. There we go. And then, last but certainly not least, I'm gonna make this smaller because this is a smaller surface. There we go. There we go. And we get that payoff of we still have the higher opacity, so it's a little bit more like thicker paint than else. But that's all right. There we go. Now let me get a smaller brush, but make it a deeper purple. There we go. And with that, we can shade. And we are going to want a bigger shading tool than 5% size. There we go. That is how I like to see a face painted. I adore this. Already I adore this. This is amazing. We're gonna do this real quick. Actually, no. All right. Well, let's even out the cheeks. There we go. You really want these cheeks to pop and be strong, like really, really vibrant, in terms of like the shape of them. This is a very strong boned sort of person that we're painting here, you know? No, I can probably do that with a smaller one, actually. We want there to feel like it's not constantly. And then you have the nose shape, which is really well done with the way that I've done it. What do you think? What do you think? Just based on the face, I'm very pleased with how that's come out. Very, very pleased with that. I can happily move on from that. And that face will only be lit up even more by firelight, of course, later. And this will create the depth of the arm because I did shade both the side. Okay. We're gonna want to clean up around that arm. We were mercied because not a lot of the ear had shade. The ear is like the only really the only place where you might want to clean it up. Since the face is insulated by a bunch of the other layers, protecting it from needing to be cleaned up. But we're gonna want to clean up this arm. So let's do that. Let's get background reference, because that is going to more clearly show. I don't know if you can see it, but I can see exactly now where that shading is that I need to clean up outside the lines. That way, when I inevitably, I won't be doing it with this, of course, you know, with the background that I mentioned, but it's one of those things that you can make it transparent if you want. Now, this one doesn't work as well being transparent because of all the other background. But the idea that you can, I always like leaving that an option. So I like to shade everything and then clean it up immediately after, because it saves me so much time later than having to do it in that moment. And this is also going to have a lot of like insulated shading. There we go. Now, I'm also not good at doing like some of the more like finer details on the hands, but I think like that's one of those things that stylistically, like eventually I know that I should learn and I will, but not necessarily now, you know what I mean? You pick and choose your battles, what you want to practice. Oh, I'm feeling it in my back. We're going to need to take a break soon. Just so I can maybe try to stream a little bit longer today, because I would like to, but that does mean maybe taking like a 5-minute break. And so I will be, I'll be doing that. I just need to find a be back in 5 sort of a thing, you know? I would like to make this a continual thing, paint a little bit more, that way I'm doing a little bit more than just like fast filling in a bunch of stuff and then shading one layer. That feels a little bit lazy, and I would not, and I don't want to feel like I'm being lazy about that. Now the good thing is, I don't just do this. I know eventually I would like to be able to stream some games. I've mentioned this again, I've also mentioned this in previous streams, but I would like to be able to stream some other games, some games as well. Not D&D, I think that's the decision I've come to, but things like Animal Crossing on the Switch. I kind of enjoy that as a game, as an idea. We're shaded with the scars in mind. We know the scars are there. gonna shade for the eyes and mouth now. There we go. It's a long name for that layer, but also think maybe I could have put a little bit more on the nose, but I think we can get the point across well enough. And we will be doing, and we have the food firelight layer as well. Again, we're playing with fire in that way. So we're going to get this, and we're going to set the opacity to much lower, like 28, being generous. And we're going, nope. I actually think this tool size is probably just fine. And it's still in the eye. Alright. Let me make this tool 5. And we'll clean up around the eye as needed. But we wanna make sure that this, you can really see that light, you know? You really see he's not amused. And it's not just the face, it's like all over where we're getting dynamic kind of facial expressions. And then, okay. So, absolutely, we need to now let's just go for a little bit of one, a little bit of shine. There we go. All right. 3. We do not need a brush bigger than that, but we do need to sort of create the sort of shape of it, which is what we're doing here. And that, I think, is about as much as we're going to get out of that lip. It's not the most well versed for that sort of thing. Unfortunately, with having done white hair, it would be a little difficult to put lighting somewhere. But I can put the shading very easily. Right. Remember to stay hydrated as long as it's liquid and not like alcohol. It's fine. You will be hydrated from it. So we're gonna put this sort of silvery tone here. Okay. Ba-ba-ba-ba. I will say, I am going to try to stream a little bit longer. I did need that 5-minute break just to sort of reset my head a little bit. But I will be trying to stream for a little bit longer. I'm not sure for how long, but I do know I'm gonna try for almost 2 hours if possible. So feel free to hang out and get comfortable. There we go. We are getting to the part of this painting where it is going to be a little bit more difficult to see what to see some of the shading I'm adding, because this is a white hair, which makes it a little harder to see where the shading actually is going. Here we go. Boom. And it's at 28, I just realized. So that's on me. That is on me. Okay. Let me amend that. There we go. All right. And then I set this back to that a little bit. No, just for over here. I am being a bit of a doofus. Okay, this is fine. And then we get the five blending tool. We don't need to get too fancy with the shading on this area. I will say, music that I've found, which is Mozart, just in general Mozart, feels a lot like it belongs in Pride and Prejudice. I've been watching that with a friend of mine over the last few weeks. Taking my good time with it because it's not quite the speed I'm used to watching stuff at. And I'm still not even sure where to find it now on my own. It usually looks it up for me. But it does have like Pride and Prejudice vibes. A lot of. Oh, I have a question, actually, for anyone who might be here and is still listening. Did anyone here ever watch that kids show? What's it called? It was that musical show with where the kids would like solve problems with music, and they had a rocket in this magic treehouse of sorts. Because I remember that, and it was like my favorite thing in the world. Music is one of my favorite things in the world. I don't know if I could live without it, honestly. It's amazing. But yeah, no, it's that also comes to mind. There we go. So we have the hair shaded. Because we can't do the lighting on it. Not even like the natural lighting. I can't do the natural lighting on it yet. About that. I'm good. Hydration and making sure you're getting snacks as needed is very important. Listen to your body. Right, so now we're doing the wraps shading, which I think I can safely. Ooh, we're gonna need to make this higher opacity right now. There we go. Put that here. And then we'll clean up some of the shading on this afterwards. But first, we need to get some of that lighting in as well. 'Cause this is facing where the firelight is as well. So let's make this a tool size of 10. No, let's make this a tool size of 20, actually. So I can make it a little bit softer and a little bit more blended out. Man, let me tell you, the art tools on this thing take a lot of time. There we go. There we go. There we go. Now that is satisfying to see, like, all of it becomes shaded, and when it's not just the one layer that's shaded, but all of it. I really enjoy seeing a piece come together like this. Next is pants shading. See, layer by layer, we are almost done shading this body. And then we can actually get into the background, as it were. Okay. All right. So we have this gray that I need to go a little bit darker than. I just cracked my neck. I apologize if you heard that crack. I don't know why it needed to be cracked already. And then we want to do that. I don't know that I made this dark enough, but we have that going on. Let's see. I might need to make it darker. There we go. Let me actually make this the screen, and then I can a little bit more safely engage with this, just to see what this means. There we go. Alright. And we are absolutely gonna have to do cleanup on this. That is A-okay. There we go. And then we get a lighter. Oh boy, no, we do not need it to be that light. Let's see, does this work? It works! That works, that is not too light. You really want to balance out where the how light you're going with the shading. Unless it really is that kind of environment. In which case, cool, 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 you know? That won't always be the case. I'm trying to be mindful of where the lighting is coming from as well. Because there are several layers of the shading here. I'm being mindful of that to try to, there we go, let's. Ooh, you know what I... Okay, I have to be real. I have to be honest. I have a guilty pleasure. And I say this knowing, of course, everybody has a guilty pleasure. But, it comes to mind with the music that I'm listening to that, that is separate. But, do you guys know La La Land? I know there was, like, this infamous thing at, like, the Emmys, I want to say? Because it was named for, like, Best Feature Film or something. But I have to admit, it is one of my guilty pleasures. Because I watched it, around my 19th birthday, I want to say. And, it was one, and, I watched it while I was on a major trip for the first time to see my partner at the time. And, the movie's kind of hot garbage. Absolutely. Prefacing it with that. Absolute kind of hot garbage. But not all that great about, like, the way it treats jazz, even though it's the main theme of the movie. But, I really enjoy the music in it. And if I can ignore the way that, the way that Ryan Gosling and Emma's characters are sort of set up to be together, I enjoy the way that the end happens as well. It's beautiful and kind of heartbreaking. And it's got really nice background music throughout all of it. The way that the themes intertwine together, I really enjoy that factor. But absolutely, I enjoy some of the witty songs. Even if it is a little hot garbage about the way that it like treats the history of jazz, because the history of jazz is absolutely not as white as the movie. Because the movie gets a little bit white savory about it. That's not what you're here for. Listening to kind of classical music reminds me a little bit of that at the moment. There we go. There we go. I also wonder, how many of you play Animal Crossing? I know I'm not likely to get a response. It's fine. I'm mostly kind of talking to myself at the moment. And that's okay. I'm kind of debating what I want to do with my island, because I know I have just about everything you could possibly get on the island in the game. I'm taking my sweet time with Happy Home Paradise, which has been a very good DLC and absolutely worth the money that I spent on it. It was like one of the things that I got as part of my, like, after I finished a commission. I got Happy Home Paradise, and it was really, really good. It's been really, really good. It's been really fun. Challenging my, like, artistic, like, designing chops, if that makes sense. But even on my main island, starting to get a little bit tired of my current design. But I have no clue what I want to do, because what I have right now is a lot more about, like, suburb core. I tried cottage core with my first island, and I think I mostly succeeded. But all the houses were a little bit more spread out, and so this time I kind of did, you know what? What if everyone just lived in a neighborhood? And so on my island, there are, like, a bunch of different, three spots of houses, that are all kind of grouped together the way a neighborhood might be, and I have designed around that. So, definitely suburb core, which is where I'm at right now. That said, also, we are almost done. I think what I'm gonna do is I might finish shading the body, and then we'll see how I feel about continuing to stream. Just see if maybe I can do the basic background in my own time. But I think I might end the stream sooner rather than later. For which I apologize. Oh boy, did I forget. I forgot. Okay. There we go. Now I can do that. Okay, thank you. Would not have noticed that. That is on me. Vest. Vest shading. Where do I want to put these things? Okay, that is still lighter. Okay. That is the shade that is. Okay. I'm having to trial and error. There we go! There we go. I'm happy with that. I'm happy with that. We go. And then I absolutely think this is a good way to go. And then I'm going to put 10 here. Pen size tool, just so I know for a fact. I'm also going to put, like, shading around the buttons just to, like, get rid of the shading that is actually on the buttons. Because I think that, like, very, very interesting. Ooh, shading lines. I can't believe I almost forgot entirely about the shading lines. Because this ish absolutely is here. Okay, oh, that's lighting. Okay. I had to remember what my own note said. So I apologize for that. That may be little touch and go. Yeah, there we go. we go. And then we're going to put a much smaller thing here. Yeah, this is, yeah, I think I really enjoy the way that I have my lighting, the way that I mark it, because it's extremely helpful, like, extremely so. Oh boy, okay, 15. Let's see, that is much more. That is much more decently put. Awesome, okay. And then I can. Yeah, and there we go. And then again, we're just gonna. 3. I'm gonna put some shading around that, around these buttons. Just to make sure that they have some dimension to them. And we'll just clean them up as we go. Alright, so now we will be doing this. Creating this line art will, this shading line will be removed, for the final piece as well, by the way. So this is going to look a little awkward because I have these lines here, but this is specifically called the shading lines layer, so that like when it comes to shading, that is where I know exactly where to shade and where to remove them. You know, very important to have something like this if this is like a project sometimes. At least for me it is. There we go, alright. And then there we go, alright. So I think it's time to clean up. There we go. There we go. Absolutely gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Alright. Oh, it occurs to me. I talked about that Pride and Prejudice thing a little bit ago. ADHD brain. So my brain still kind of sits on that sometimes. But it's not the one with Keira Knightley in it. If anyone who is watching this back or watching it now is interested in trying to find it. I think it was made before the Keira Knightley version, although I do want to watch the Keira Knightley version. I am extremely gay. And most self-respecting lesbians are aware of the gorgeousness of Keira Knightley. So and also just her acting chops are amazing. And I wanna see like how that came out. Oh my gosh. Ah! There we go. Alright. So we've got that. Let's clean up just over the buttons where there wouldn't be shading. And then I can take off this layer shading lines. There we go. Isn't that gorgeous? Isn't that gorgeous? Because that's where the lighting is going to be. There we go. I love this already. There we go. And we've created that dimension. Now, and the last thing that I'm going to shade in here is the handkerchief. The shading of the handkerchief. There we go. Ah. Again, I'm going to stretch after the stream as well because, oh boy, am I feeling it. Oh boy, yeah, I'm feeling it. Do not be like me. Don't paint Don't sit on your computer on the not very soft floor. It's not good for your back. I do not recommend it. There we go. I can probably make that. Here we go. Okay, yeah. Come on. Paint program. Get with the program. Right. Oh, all right. No, we need to make that little darker. Little bit more vibrant. Perhaps I could have gone that darker route. There we go. And then we have this shade in. And now we can put a lot more of like a normal red out. Let's see. Yeah, cool. Okay. So now I am going to make this a size 7 tool. Probably a little bigger than it needs to be, but that's all right. There we go. All right. There we go. All right. I know I keep saying that, so I apologize if that does not make sense. I am trying to find all the shapes. There we go. All the shapes. That is what art is. Yes. All right. I think I'm gonna make that yet smaller, just a little bit. Not much smaller, but just I want to keep that like the sort of shape that I'm trying to create with this shading. Because that's what shading is. It's to create shapes in the art, without using lines. There we go. What do we think? I think I'm pretty happy with this. I am. Think I'm pretty happy with this. I think. Oh, I know what I'll do. What I'll do is I will make something in the center as well. Just give that even more, like, because oftentimes you will see things sort of get even lighter in the center as like more light is hitting the center than otherwise, you know? So I just want to create that sort of illusion that light is hitting it. There we go. All right. Now with that, we're just gonna shade this real quick. There we go. So we know that we're not gonna get any weirdness going on. I think I may also need to do the so the background, so the flooring of the Pause My Art is pretty solid. Let me save this painting. There we go. But I may need to cut it earlier. Which is what I think I'll do very briefly with the line art. One, full opacity. And then 100% smoothing. Because That's what I thought would happen. Okay. So, what I'll be doing next stream, if I'm still working on this, which I might end up working more on this tonight, just because there is a lot of background to work with. There's sky, there's all that fun stuff, you know? And you kind of want all of it to be even. Sorry. And I think like this is one of those pieces that I'm going to sit on for a while, in that in a way that I mean like I'm just not going to stop working on it. I'll take breaks. I'll take like a finger break. That is to say, like tonight I am gonna relax best of my ability. But not necessarily stop painting this once I have taken that break. So that will be what's happening with that. Although I will do my best to make sure I don't finish it entirely if I can off stream. If you want to see the completed pieces as I finish them, then you can follow me on my Twitter. You can follow me on our Twitter. You can follow me on our Tumblr. I know I don't mention the Tumblr very much, but that's because Tumblr is Tumblr, you know what I mean? No one's you don't exactly go advertising that. That being said, Digital Art for the Soul, dashes between each word, is our Tumblr for is our art Tumblr. Should you be interested in finding that? That is where I also share all of my work. So now I have the line art, and I can put, I can do the dirt there. Yeah, I think I'm good for the day. Here's this drow without all the without the fire lighting, which will be fun. But by the time we get back, I at least probably will have finished the general shading of the background, and theoretically, I will be doing a lot of the firelight on stream. Firelight with the with that last painting I've been doing that I did on stream was very fun and a super interesting challenge that I really enjoyed doing. So I kind of want to play with that a little bit. Especially because I saw this pose on Pose My Art and I just couldn't resist. All right, so I'm gonna save once more just in case. Always double save if you can. Or maybe that's just my brain going, okay, time to make sure. That being said, I am going to end off the stream here. I hope you did enjoy it. And thank you for those who kind of stuck around. If you painted alongside me, absolutely tag me on Twitter, Clockwork Sis, SYS, not CIS. I am one and not the other. Tag me on Clockwork Sis if you painted alongside me at all today. I would love to see what you made if that's if you are comfortable sharing, of course. And I will hopefully be back with the stream. In the very least, if not tomorrow, on Wednesday. I would like to make this a lot more of a frequent thing that I'm doing. Depending on what I have access to. In between art streams, I'd like to do more video game stuff. Since I have like a capture card for the Switch, as that is my main format of playing video games. And I would like to be able to get more games and such to be able to play for this stream, and then in my own time beyond that, so I can enjoy it for myself without without looking like a fool not knowing what I'm doing at least. But yes, so I hope you've been so I hope you enjoyed the stream. Make sure that you get a snack if you haven't had it, that you have that you get something to drink if you haven't, and that you stretch if you did paint. Gotta take care of your body. All right, have a lovely day.